supposed to make it through. You should know me. You're my angel. Nothing's gonna make you fall from heaven. Girl, I just wanna love you.
Oh. Oh, y'all thought it was over? Oh, we got a new show, man. So, we got more questions, more things popping. But this time, man, I want to bring my viewers on, man. So this is a show for us, man. I want some viewers to come on. I want some viewers to come on. And I want you to ask questions, man. This is, like us, you know, relationship therapy, man. This is something that, hey, what's going on, man? We got motherfucking Bone up in here, man. You already know, man. So this one, man, we're going to ask relationship, you know, questions, man. This one, man, ladies, man, you can tell me, man, or ask me, man, what you're going through, what a guy's thinking, and I'm going to tell you, man, what I think a guy's thinking or where you should go, man. So this is a different twist. Of course, we still got some crazy questions, man, that we're going to get to, man, that we left off from the other first list. But, you know, we want everybody, man, to tune in, man, and get back on the road, man. It's a different show, man. So if you want to come in and you have a question, you're going to come on the camera, man, and ask your question, man. So if you have something that you're thinking about, you know, this is a different flavor from the other show. You know, ask your relationship question, and I'm going to try to answer it, man. Or if you have something that you just want to talk about, you know, bring it on in, man. So it's a little different from the other show, man, that just went off, man. For those who missed it, you can go to, you know, tune in. It was a crazy and wild show, man. You know, a lot of viewers, man, a lot of laughs, man. So you can check that out, man. But we also have some other different flavors, man. So this is, man, you know, kind of a relationship, you know, show. But again, man, you can tune in, man. We're going to have some crazy questions that I need to ask my viewers. Guys still want to know what's going on in the bedroom, man. So it's a little bit like that, man. This is a shorter show, man, about 30, 40 minutes, man. So we're going to tune on in, man, you know. But let me grab up the stuff, man, so we can go going. All right. So like I said, man, we're going to still get a couple of, you know, questions in, man. You know what I mean? From the old stuff, man. So if any ladies, man, have a, you know, relationship, you know, question, what you think their guy's doing or whatever, man, or whatever, hit me up, man. I'll try to answer it. But, you know, let's get into the crazy stuff first, man. I was wondering, like, how long does it take for a woman to decide, you know, if you're serious? Like, what's the going time, man, for a woman, man, like, to, you know, I'm really serious about a guy, man, you know, is it something that, you know, you do it right away? Or is it something that, you know, it takes over time? It takes 6 months. It takes a year. Like, when does a woman know or she wants to get serious with a guy? Like, how long should it take for y'all to get serious? 1 month, 2 months, 3 months? I'm anxious to know, man, you know. What's your take, man, on that? Hey, what's going on, Marie, man? How you doing, man? Again, this show is a little different than the next one, last one. So on this show, man, you can come on the show. I'll actually bring you on camera. You can ask a question, man, a relationship question. And it's for all of us to really, you know, to tag in, man. You know, what you think a guy might be doing, man, or whatever a girl might be doing. You know, listen, man, it's for us to, you know, figure it out amongst ourselves, man. So you saying it takes like 6 months. So 6 months is an ideal time for you to be like, listen, it's time to get serious for with a guy. So does everybody agree with that? Like 6 months, after 6 months, you know, you should know that, like, yeah, serious 6 months for me. So 6 months is like the ideal time for a woman to be like, okay, you know, we need to settle down and everything. Okay. Some guys, man, you know, listen, you know, you got those stalker guys, man. You know what I mean? They lock you down in 2 weeks, man. You know what I mean? So she's like 6 months, man. You know what I mean? 6 months seems to be standard, but you know, listen. Some ladies are like, listen, man. I know when I put my eyes on a guy, man. So I want to know, man. Like, what's an ideal time, man? You know, for you to lock down a guy, man. So it's a little crazy. We still gonna get crazy, man. You know what I mean? But this one's different. Like I said, man, you can come on, you know, screen and ask a relationship question, man, you know? So this one right here is for everybody, you know what I mean? Listen, everybody figure it out. We all gonna figure it out together, you know what I mean? So, ladies, if a guy has skinny legs, what does that mean for the rest of his package? What do y'all think it means for, if a guy has skinny legs, does he got a big dick? They got a small dick? Like, in your take, if he got skinny legs, what the fuck the rest of the body look like, man? You know what I mean? Ladies, let me ask you that, man. If he has skinny legs, does he got a big dick? Does he got a small dick? I heard we already said the small niggas, man, be packing. You said the little five-footed niggas, man. Them motherfucker, I go by the feet. Dick doesn't matter. Big dick or male. Nicole said, dick doesn't matter. Not on this show, we've already gone to that. Nigga, we going to that. All the ladies say, dick matter. They say, don't come to the motherfucking show, nigga, with no motherfucking half-stepping, nigga. And nigga, you talking about dick don't matter? Listen, man. Man, you haven't been on this show, man. They done kicked some dudes out mid-fucking, nigga. Talk about dick matter. They like big black dick matter. They been saying that shit. I don't know. There's only one time marriage, and even that has stipulations. I could dig that. The shoes. So the shoes sell it all? So if the nigga got the big shoes, so the big 13 shoes, so you talking about the big 13 shoes matter. And some little ducks be hitting some spots, though. Marie, the women have been saying that. They've been saying that, you know what I mean? That you need, all you need is 2 inches, right? 2-3 inches. All you need is 2-3. He got to work it. He got to work it. She like, he got to work it. That motherfucker got a motherfucker. He got to do the motherfucker wave on that motherfucker. It depends. Sometimes you got to connect right away. Sometimes you don't. I think that's true, man. I think, like, people, man, honestly, man, if you have to fucking, you know, it's all about chemistry, man. You know what I mean? It's all about connecting with someone. If you connect with someone, the dick could be trash, man. But in your mind, nigga, that's the best dick ever. Same thing with pussy, man. Don't think, nigga. Listen, some of y'all be having some dried up pussy, man. That shit been, nigga, desert, nigga. Niggas been, listen, nigga, been crawling on top of that motherfucker. That shit been dried up. But nigga love the fuck out of you, man. You know what I mean? That nigga take your motherfucking panties and just, you know what I mean, when you ain't home, man. So that type of shit, man, he gonna know. He gonna think that shit is bomb as fuck. You know what I mean? So, little dick, big dick, man, I think it's all about chemistry. It depends. Sometimes you connect right away. Sometimes you don't. True. He gotta work. I'll leave a little dick nigga right where he couldn't find his own shit. Damn, mamacita. You know what I mean? You know, listen. With a last name like Strong, you already put your motherfucking foot down where you going. Like, listen. If it ain't Strong, nigga, if a nigga don't come in, nigga, listen. That means you want a nigga come in, nigga. His shit just come in the door, nigga, just like this. Have his pants standing up. Like, if his shit ain't Strong, nigga, coming in the door, nigga, he getting the fuck out, nigga. Damn, nigga. That's the pop. I get it, man. Damn. Hey, what's up, Shizzy Mac, man? Damn, mamacita. Okay, man. You know what I mean? So, I want to know, man, the truth, man. You know what I mean? Let's cut the bullshit, man. Let's cut the bullshit. On a women's trip, man, out of 7 women, man, how many motherfucking women are cheating, man? How many women are cheating, nigga, on a women's trip out of seven, man? You know what I mean? We're not saying you. We're just saying, man, out of a women's trip, man, how many women's, man, is dropping those goddamn drawers, man? How many ladies, man, came back to the hotel room with no panties, man? I'm interested to know. She has to be able to take the dick and fuck back with all she has. You already know, big boat. Big bone. You understand me? They don't call you bone for nothing. I like a nice size dick. Not too just big, just right. Damn, she's like, listen, nigga. Michelle want to chisel her shit. She's like, I don't like my shit too big. I don't like my shit too small. I like my shit, nigga, just right, nigga, like in the porridge, nigga. You know what I mean? I like my shit just, nigga, she just chiseling her shit down, nigga. I mean, when she get her shit, she's like, I'm keeping my shit. This shit just right. This porridge is just motherfucking right, nigga. You know what I mean? I can dig that. She's like, damn. That shit was too hot. Too cold. I mean, my shit just right. I'm a weirdo. I love being loyal to my king. Okay, then. I get that. I don't believe in cheating, so I can't relate. Man. We're not talking about you. We talking about the group. We talking about the other skanky assholes that you be going out with. We talking about them. We ain't talking about you. Listen, we already know. Y'all gonna leave, nigga. Y'all got the lock pussy, man. Nigga, they come in, nigga, with the motherfucking padlock on your shit. We know that shit. We talking about the other skanky hoes you be going out with. What about them? What about them chicks that don't come back with no panties? Not everybody just come back, nigga, just enjoy the music, nigga. You know what I mean? Listen, nigga, I've been on vacation. I done motherfucking went through all kind of motherfucking groups. So how the hell? Oh, listen, nah, nobody motherfucking have nothing. I don't know. Ain't none of these chicks be from Miami, man, but everybody fucking, nigga. I don't get that shit. No chick be from Miami, but everybody fucking. So I guess nobody fucking, nigga. Lick it. Okay, then. Nigga want that big tongue, man. I was wondering, man, like, nowadays you can't let nobody know what you doing. Fair to say that. I know there's crickets. There's over here crickets like, oh, nobody be doing nothing that motherfucker. And our family, listen, man. I don't know, man. Listen, man. Somebody fucking, man, now. Every fucking trip, nigga. So, you know what I mean? Gotta be one person, nigga. Listen, so let me ask you at this, man. Outside of a bedroom, ladies, man, like, what's the one place a guy needs, like, he's sleeping on? Like, what's the one place a guy can fuck you outside of the bedroom that'll turn you into a freak for right there in the moment? Like, what's that spot? Is, you know, the counter, the shower, you know what I mean? The fucking, the over the couch, nigga. Shit, maybe it's in the kids' room, nigga. Like, what's the one spot that, like, you, it's a secret thrill for you to fuck? I want to know that. Like, what gets fucking females turned on, especially on a girl's trip? In public. Yeah, in public, but I'm talking about in the bedroom. Like, you know, we're going to get to it in public, man, all over the house. But where, like, what spot? Like, what spot do you really, the shower? She's like, man, just throw me up against the goddamn tiles, nigga. Huh? You motherfucker just like, you know what I mean? You stuck, nigga. You come off the tiles, nigga. Soap all running down you, man. You know what I mean? You know a motherfucker. Hey, man, I get it. The couch or the shower. On the toilet. On the toilet. I've tried everything, man. Of course, on the toilet, too. But damn, on the toilet. I don't know, man. Like, I don't want a nigga, man. You know what I mean? You motherfucking that, you know, when you're on the toilet, that cold air come up onto your ass, man. You know what I'm saying? I don't know, man, about the motherfucking toilet, man. You know what I'm saying? Maybe the seat's down, man. You know what I mean? Yeah, man. I'm into exhibition. Hey, man, I like a little exhibition to do, man. Shit, man. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing wrong with a little exhibitionist, man. You know what I mean? Ain't nothing with, hey, running, hey. You know what I'm saying? If you've been on the past shows, y'all know, listen, ain't nothing I ain't done, man. From the jacuzzis to the pools, man, to, you know, to the malls, man, up in the dressing rooms, man. I've done it on, you know, cars, man, the beaches, man, you know, out in the open, man. Listen, man, I feel like you should live life and do things, man, if you're missing out on the stairs. I've done it a million stairs, man. Shit, I've done it in a few stairs. I've done it on the side of some of a few, you know, popular motherfucking restaurants around here too, man. You know what I mean? I love the balcony. I love the balcony. Balcony's always nice. You know what I mean? Balcony's always nice. I like to paint over the couch. That motherfucker, hey, that love handle be there for a reason over the couch, nigga. It don't be there for an armrest. You know what I mean? You supposed to be bent over that thing. You know what I mean? Yeah, that's perfect motherfucking back shots. Bent over the couch. I don't be ready. How you don't be ready? The red line. Oh, now she talking my business. Listen, I didn't do the red line. I did the orange line, no. And down the Copley. Yeah, I used to do that on a regular basis, man. You know what I mean? The red line and the Copley, the little elevator that go down, man. Listen, I went to Copley High, so we did that. We was acting crazy. Rooftop in NYC. Okay, then. I see. You know what they were? Shit, man. I done did a million rooftop. Matter of fact, when I came home, I did for... what was the popular club in Rhode Island, man? So I did that, man, counting down New Year's Eve, been in the bathroom. I always up for some pleasure, man. You always gotta, you know, do some shit, man. I was just coming home acting crazy, man. So, you know, I feel like you should live life, man. Do what you gotta do, man. You already know. So no one's gonna ask about the who's cheating, man. So let me ask ladies this, man. And I need y'all to come on about some relationship shit, man, because this is a relationship show, man. So if you have a relationship problem, man, or a relationship issue, man, you know, come on in, man. You know what I mean? We'll bring you in, man, and whatever. You can ask a little thing. Rooftop sounds interesting. Gotta try it. Listen, you gotta try the rooftop, man. You know what I mean? Overlooking some buildings, man. You know, the air coming, you know what I mean? Making your nipples poke out just right, man. You have your shit in there right there, man. And listen, man, back shot, man, on top, man. Listen, you definitely going to have some fun, man. A rooftop, man, or just out in the open anyway. I think, you know, just have some fun. So, let me ask ladies this. Do ladies lose respect for a man if he gets beat up? Like, do you, like, if your man, nigga, been walking around talking all big tough around the motherfucking house, if he get beat up, nigga, do you lose respect for that guy? Is that something that happens, or you like, that's my baby? You know what I mean? We here together. Shit just happens. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Look at the world, beautiful view. Damn, she's still stuck sitting on the top of that balcony. Mama Sita, like, ready to motherfucking fly, nigga. You know what I mean? No. I like that. No. Okay, then. So, no, you won't lose respect. We're going to be beat up together. Fuck that. I like that shit. Hey, man, I like that. I feel like it's a lesson learned. Hey, man, I always say, man, you can't be the baddest motherfucker in the world, man. Even Mike Tyson got beat up in his, you know, heyday, man. You know what I mean? So it's like losing is nothing to be ashamed of, man. But as long as you have someone who has your back, man, that's all you need in life, man. If you have someone that really cares for you and, you know, fuck with you, man, he should have your back the same way, man. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, man, I ain't going to let my girl get beat up, man. So, you know what I mean? Y'all better not be sitting there letting a nigga get beat up. You know what I mean? Don't be sitting there, nigga, like, I don't lose no respect for you after you let that nigga just get beat up, nigga. And they done rag that nigga down up and down the street. You're like, oh, I could have stopped it, man. You know what I mean? After the first three blows, man. But when he was dragging you by the shirt, you know what I mean? I thought he lost control. You know what I mean? Don't be that one, nigga. Like, he was dragging you by the shirt, so I didn't know. You know what I mean? No, he just took an L. Everyone lose a fight. I get that, man. I lost my campaign for city council. Well, sorry to hear that, man. You know, as always, man, we support, man, Nicole and everybody, man. You know, we're always trying to cheer, man, for everybody. You know what I mean? We want everybody to win on this stage, man. And that's why we're here, man. So you can't win them all. Can't win them all. But so, yeah. So I want to ask, ladies, man, like, do you have anything, like, in a relationship that you want to think of why a guy's doing something, or, you know, what's my take on a situation? So I'm here, man, to, you know, tell you a little bit of insight, man, about how guys are thinking. Can't win them all, but if they are, we swing them together. Damn, man, y'all are ruthless. I like that shit, man. You know what I mean? Shit, man. So anybody have any relationship questions, man? You know, shit. Or I just go into some shit, man. But I definitely want to hear some of, you know, I want to hear some of the things that you want to think of. Maybe why a guy's doing something. Maybe, you know, why are females, you know, that our friendship is, you know. I'm anxious, man, to hear a little something about, man, the things that you have on your mind, man. Because I'm always going to tell you about what's on mine, so. You'd already know. Alcohol and drugs play a big part. So, are we talking about relationships, alcohol and drugs? Because I think, like, yo, man, you know what? I think a lot of people, you know, use drugs, man, or alcohol. You know what I mean? It's just what type you use, man. You know what I mean? Me, myself, man, I never tried anything but marijuana, so it's like, yeah, you know what I mean? It's hard for someone to tell me that's never been in my life, man, or just came in my life to tell me to stop, you know, smoking weed, man. And that might be irritating to, you know, a mate, so, you know, that's always going to be an issue. Alcohol, I feel like alcohol has to be taken in consumptions no matter what, man, you know what I mean? I think that if you're dealing with alcohol, man, you know, no one likes a drunk, man. So I think, like, of course, man, the ideal thing is to drink socially. You know, that's something I do. You know what I mean? I don't like drinking when there's nothing else going on. Man, I drink on the show. But if I'm sitting around the house, I'm just not going to drink. So I think that, man, you know, moderation is a thing that we all need to take into account, man. We all need to respect our partner with, man. And it's something that, man, we should try to move with. The dating pool has pee and fungus in it. I'm single. Damn, Tammy. Has pee and fungus in it. Niggas is bad like that. Damn, I thought, man, listen, I thought things were improving, man, you know what I mean? I thought guys was starting to, you know, take, you know, just, you know, be a better people, man. So, damn, she said poo, pee, and fungus, nigga. I ain't never heard that. I grow marijuana. Ain't nothing bad about marijuana, man. To each his own, but it's how you use it. Agree, man, you know what I mean? Damn, nigga, I'm still on the motherfucking pee and fungus, nigga. Damn, motherfuckers just ain't, niggas ain't shit around here, nigga, you know what I mean? Is that all of Massachusetts or is that just Boston? Damn, you know what I mean? Pee and fungus? Damn, that sound like it's gonna stick and stink. I don't like that shit, man. Hey, ladies, let me ask you this. You know, in the porn movies, man, they be using oil and shit, man. You know what I mean? They come out, the lady come out all oiled up, man. All looking sexy ass, all shining off the goddamn light and shit. So I was wondering, has any ladies, man, ever used oil in the bedroom, man? And, like, how did that go? Like, was that a hit or was it a miss? Like, did that enhance the motherfucking action? Or were you just like, damn, I should have never fucking brought oil. That shit was messy and it fucked up the chemistry. So I want to know, like, is oil like baby oil, nigga? Like, is that the shit? Like, all the time. Oh, damn, they like this, nigga, with the, that slippery sex. That could be a trip to the ER. Damn. Damn, that's some WWE. She's like, all the time. I don't need oil. Makes it better. Damn. 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 So you mean the motherfucker mean the oil man, you know what I mean? Have you all slipping? You want a nigga to slip and slide. You want a motherfucker just come in the bedroom, nigga, and slip and slide into the pussy. Huh? Motherfucker just come in, nigga, you know what I mean? And run from the motherfucker ankles up, nigga. Damn, oil down all the time. Damn, motherfucker guy, she said make it wet better. So that's why I was asking before. Do ladies still use the oils, man, you know, to make the pussy wet? Man, is that a thing, man, you know what I mean? Do you still use the oils, man, to make the pussy, man, you know what I mean? Is that, you know what I mean? Do ladies, you know what I mean, naturally use the oils and shit? So I was just wondering this shit. That was an earlier question, man, for the other show, man, but as always, you know what I mean? And skinny guys, that's what I wanted to know about the skinny legs. Does skinny leg guys, do they have big dicks or small dicks, man? What's up with the skinny niggas, the skinny leg guys? I got skinny legs, so I was wondering. No, I just want that nigga sticking to me. Damn. I just don't want that nigga sticking to me. Damn. Okay then, man. So shit, man. My wet is regardless. Nicole, like, listen, man. Once I motherfucking pop off these panties, man, I'm gonna motherfucking gush out, nigga, like a hydrant regardless. If you need oils to make you wet, he ain't the one. That's what I wanted to know. That's what I wanted to know, ladies. If a guy, if you had need oils, does that mean a guy is not fucking, like he's not getting you turned on? Or is that like just some things? Skinny guys are usually bigger. I don't need oil. I stay wet. Damn. Like, you know what I mean? Like, is that a thing? No. Damn. So I was just always wondering, man, you know what I mean? Because, you know what I mean? Like, oil's supposed to be in handshake, man. You know what I mean? But some ladies use the oil, man. They be like, listen, I need that. So I don't know, man. Listen, man, I want the pussy to be wet, man. I like to see naturally wet. I want to see what you're working with. I want to see if that motherfucker just spurred out, nigga. No, it depends what you're using it for. My oil. That is correct. He isn't doing it for you, so why bother? Damn. So, let me ask ladies this. Are men intimidated by sexual toys, or do they like to use them in bedroom with you? Are they intimidated, or they're into it? Let me ask you that. No need for the oil. That kitty stay wet when it's time to rumble. Ha! She's like, listen, you can't, listen, nigga, don't touch this motherfucker, man, this motherfucker come snatch you up, nigga, this motherfucker ready to rumble, this nigga in the jungle. I need oil, just makes it more interesting, man, has to know your body, you naturally get wet. True that, I love a massage with the oil, and then it up in the air. That's how I was going, so I asked that earlier. How many times do you cater to your guys? How many times, you know, a week do you massage your man? And what are you like, you know, how many times does your man massage you, man? So what is your ideal to be pleased by your man, like just you time? Like, what is your ideal time? They feel like they are doing a job with toys. Some men love the toys. What kind of toy do guys like fucking, like if a guy's wanna have sex with you and he wanna bring a toy in and you wanna introduce a toy to a guy, what's the ideal toy to introduce a guy with you, like a learner's kit? Like, you don't wanna scare a guy off. So what's the ideal toy for a next lady to know? To, okay, I'm going to bring a toy into the bedroom. What's the ideal toy you say as a learner's kit for the other girls who don't, who want to bring in toys but don't use toys? So let me ask you, no, I massage his body every day. Well, God damn, that nigga got some relaxed bones. You massage him every day? Damn, I'm missing out, nigga. Damn, I don't get no loving like that. Some love watching. Ain't nothing wrong with watching. Especially the two people, let's watch. I'm not into pulling and all that shit, man. And I ain't want to watch no other nigga fuck my bitch, man. So, but two women? Shit. I watch. I be talking. You know what I mean? A little bit later, I'll shut up. But when you ain't looking, I'll be talking. Yeah, now if I watch, yeah, I watch. The bullet. The bullets, are, so you think the bullets are, damn, the bullet. I heard about the bullet back in the days. It didn't sound like no starter pistol, nigga. That don't sound like a starter pistol. The bullet ain't no starter pistol. You just don't bring the bullet into with a gun. They love those clip vibrators. Oh, y'all, I must not know. They like, they love them. Them motherfuckers come in there, nigga, with the joint, huh? And when they get the joint, that nigga come in there all crazy. Watching you play with your toy. I bring a toy to vibrate his balls. No, let me tell you. Let me, damn, Nicole, you got the clincher, nigga. That shit just, did nigga go on his balls, nigga? Nah, man, listen, man. I'm all for some shit, man, but balls are very delicate, and I ain't getting no electric shock, nigga, to my balls or something that's attached, nigga, that we might have a problem or an extra second getting off. Like, that's one thing I'm not going to play with is my balls, nigga. You know what I mean? So, the dick ring, I never tried that either. Maybe, but I definitely ain't trying the balls thing, but you know what I mean? But I love my balls. Balls is my, that's my shit, so goddamn, I don't know. Shit. I see that shit first, man. The rose. Everybody be talking about the rose, man. Sex has no rules. They say sex has no rules. Okay, you watch, and I can show you one woman will make you think you have two women at the same time. Oh, damn. That means she got the motherfucking long tongue. That means her tongue go down to here. Her tongue going longer than my motherfucking bed. Master, oh, damn. That shit just trap rapping. I never had no shit like that. I seen some shit like that, man, when ladies be on that Instagram and shit, man, they pull that shit out. I be like, that's a long-ass goddamn tongue. But I ain't never seen that. So you won't let her suck on your ball? What do you mean I won't let her suck on my ball? That's my shit. You must not been on my show. Come on, man. Listen, I tell you, that's my number. I used to be not into fucking, you know, getting a dick. So like that wasn't my thing. Like, all growing up, I'm like, yo, you can suck on my dick. That's cool. But if you lick on my balls, nigga, that's going to make me, you know what I mean? Like that's going to make me, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? Like, that, man, you might have me, motherfucker, because the balls are my shit. But then again, nigga, you know what I mean? If you really know what you're doing with them lips, nigga, dick sucking is shit. So, I mean, a lady just got to know what she's doing. The rose is crazy. That'll make your legs jolt straight out. You get your stomach Charlie horses and everything. Damn, Tammy. You sound like, nigga, you done motherfucking used all the batteries up in the rose, nigga. Yo, you done went through all five stages, nigga, of the rose in one motherfucking shot, nigga. They like, yo, she's like, listen, we just get you to the motherfucking, your leg shaking. You got to the straight out, nigga, your stomach, nigga. You done turned into a damn motherfucking, into the casket mode, nigga. You done laid it there and then laid, they could have laid you in a goddamn casket. The rose is crazy. That'll make your leg go. Nigga, he had you nigga like this, nigga. God damn. Nigga, I had a whole motherfucking lockup in the whole body, nigga. That crazy. Tammy Page, okay. I'm single, damn it. Hey, man, listen, I ain't mad at you, man. I'm not mad at you, man. You gotta have some fun, man. Everybody, man, gotta have some fun, man. You know what I mean? So, you know, it's just, it is what it is, man. You know what I mean? So, let me ask you this, ladies. What's more exciting? Is it exciting to, for a round-the-way guy or an out-of-state nigga, man? You know what I mean? Someone might even be out-of-state, maybe be out-of-town. Like, what do you find more exciting? Do you find bossing my dudes to be more exciting? You find out-of-state or out-of-town guys? Like, who right now got the juice, man? Who's right now, man, got you, man, popping? But again, I also want to hear some relationship stories, man. You know what I mean? This right here, man, is for you to talk about, man, things that you're going out of state. Damn, she got the juices popping off, nigga. Damn, out of state, nigga, the juices. Damn, nigga. You know what I mean, nigga? That means, nigga, damn, they get you wet as soon as these motherfuckers cross the motherfucking state line. She's like, as soon as I get out of mass, my pussy get wet. My pussy start getting juicy, nigga, as soon as I get out of mass. I see that motherfucking four clover sign. I'm like, I'm glad to be out this bitch. Damn. She's like, you know it. Damn. Okay, Tammy, you damn out of state. I moved to California from Boston. Okay, Nicole, she's like, listen, nigga, they got... That Boston had that motherfucking Beantown hammer. Okay, then. Someone came down with the motherfucking Red Sox motherfucking swinger. You know what I mean? New York men make the panties come off quick. What is it about New York? Is it the accent? Is it, you know what I mean, the swag, man? Tell me, what is it about New York niggas? Is it the way they talk to you, man? Is it, you know, is it just the essence of being in New York? New York got a different swag. I say that, man. Like, New York is different than Boston. So what is it about New York that make ladies, man, you know, be attracted to New York, man? So I'm interested in knowing that. It's definitely the swag. It's definitely the swag. You like the way they talk? Is it the way they talk, man? Come over. They like, come over. Yo, New York? New York niggas are the ops. But listen, they smooth as hell. Some of them are aggressive as hell. Like, yo, ma, get your ass over here. You know what I mean? Hey, do you like when they come off to you like aggressive, man? Like, is it the swag or is it like the aggressive tone they come off to you? Is it like that get over here type of swag? Is that what you like or is it like... They just got a smooth way of coming at you. Like, hey, ma, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? Which way is that? Man, it's definitely the New York, man. Becca. Okay, Becca. Let me ask you a question. Some men like to be touched by the asshole. Do that mean that they are gay? I asked this question early on, right? So I asked this question early on. I said, let's cut the myth short. Do guys like to be finger popped? You know what I mean? Do you find guys grabbing your hand like, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? You're like, oh, where that going? And you're like, oh shit. So I asked ladies that in the last episode, do guys like to be finger popped? And do you consider that gay? I'm going to tell you what I consider in a second, but do you consider it gay if guys like to be finger pumped? I think it's a little gayish, you know what I mean? Nothing, you know, to each his own. But there ain't won't be no finger popping over here, you know what I mean? You ain't going to go near my motherfucking ass. So. But I mean, do I consider it gay? Fuck yeah. I think you niggas some fruity shit going on, but you know what I mean? Some niggas like pleasure like that. You know what I mean? I think it's a different thing, so I don't know. So, New York Knicks is a small, I don't know. No aggressive shit. No aggressive shit. You don't like aggressive shit. Yes, that aggression. So, Tammy's like no. Becca's like yes. Like, get over here. Get your ass over here, ma. You know what I mean? Smack you in the ass, man. She's like, oh, that shit get my pussy wet. It's the confidence. That's true. I think New York niggas, you know, come down, you have a lot of confidence, man. I think, man, at the same time, man, they do have a different type of swag, man. So, you know what I mean? Me, I think I have a state-to-state swag, man. But, you know, shit, man. You know, a lot of niggas ain't like that. My daughter's father is from Harlem, New York. Man, a lot of good dudes there, man. But I said there's good dudes everywhere, man. You know what I mean? So, nothing, man, nothing to think. Yes, they gay as fuck. Okay, Marie, long, you know, Tom. Tammy, you know we breath been for 36 years for a reason. That New York swag, man, they be like, fuck all that, man. These Boston niggas is bullshit. Well, hell, let me take the trip to New York. Hey, man, Renee, man, I guess so, man. He's right here, man. Talking about, man, New York, man, is popping, man. You know what I mean? She got me motherfucking getting ready to motherfucking get a motherfucking area code out there, address, man, or something, man. They like New Yorkers over there, man, with all the niggas, man, getting on. Not all New York niggas are smooth. Yeah, I know some rough niggas. Now, I don't know all the smooth niggas. I know some rough around the red. Maybe I'm in the wrong borough, man, because, shit, I'm not messing with the asshole. So, Nicole, you ain't never finger popped a dude, man? You know what I mean? You ain't never had a dude try to get you there? I'm not with that shit either, man. You know what I mean? Men G-spots are in their asses doesn't mean they're gay. Tammy, I don't know who the fuck told you men G-spots are in their asses, okay? You know what I mean? That is definitely, man, some Caucasian shit, man. If they told you, man, that black men got a G-spot, nigga, in they ass, man, then, nigga, then we been missing. I've been missing the mark all my goddamn life, nigga. I ain't never been pleased, nigga, because there ain't no way that a motherfucker went in my asshole and pressed something, man, and it gave me all kind of pleasure. It ain't going to never happen in my life. So there you go. So I'm not going to say that they gay or not, but I'm just going to say, not in my ass you going to play. You know, it just happened. Yeah, not in my ass. You know. The aggression has to be as gay as just God does it. Renee, let's go. Let me show you. Hey, there you go. Shit, man. Yes. I'm just messing with you. I know it ain't no God gave you thing, man. Listen. I know a couple of guys, man, that we used to clown, man. You know, that I know personally, man, once we found out that they was getting finger popped, girls was like, yo, they getting finger popped, and we thought it was like, we going crazy. Like, oh, you like what the fuck you like. So I know it ain't all what. I ain't know it ain't all Caucasian. Believe me. But nah, not with me. You bath with rubber, ducky? Nobody should be eating ass. I don't play with no type of booty hole. And you ain't playing in mine. Leftover doodle. Nah, but listen, man. Listen. Women, that's the new thing, nigga. All the women talking about, you know, you gotta eat the motherfucking groceries, man. You know what I mean? Like, and that's why we had a, you know, proper thing going. How should a woman eat? You know, how should a man eat ass? How should a woman eat ass? Should you flick it? Should you stick it, man? Or should you rim it, man? You know what I mean? We needed to know. Flick it. Flick it, fucking stick it, nigga, or rim it, nigga. You know what I mean? Listen, everybody got their thing. I'm not in, nigga, don't lick my ass. I'm not into that shit. And I ain't definitely eating nobody's ass, so we ain't got to worry about that. But hey, man, you know, each its own, man. You know what I mean? So what we're going to do is, man, since we didn't get any comments, man, is we want everybody, man, to, after this, if you can, drop some relationship, you know, some relationship issues, man, that, you know, you think, or you might want to know what a guy's going through, man. You know what I mean? What a guy is thinking, man. And I want to, you know, answer those questions, man. So if you have a relationship issue, if you think, man, you know, something that, you know, shit, hit me up. You don't have to put it on my Facebook. You can inbox me, and that's something I want to address. So, again, man, you know, of course, man, if you have leftover doo-doo, I pair you have bad hygiene. If she ain't fresh out the shower, nothing gets licked. I agree, man. You gotta get in there and come out the shower. You want a motherfucker to eat the pussy, ass, whatever, man. You know what I mean? Eat mine all day. Damn. Damn. She's like, I eat mine all day, nigga. She just put the motherfucker butt cheeks like this and just have them flap. You know what I mean? This motherfucker had them flap, nigga, right there on the cheek. Damn. I have a relationship issue. There are people on my 600-pound life where people wiping their ass and I can't find a decent man in them. Damn. Well, I think, man, when it comes to finding a guy, man, I think that everybody has someone that they're going to eventually find, man, or everybody has a person, man, that eventually is going to come through their path. A lot of the times that we either hurt by something else, we're in a different situation with someone else, or it's just not the right timing. So a lot of times, man, you might already found your ideal man. It just might have not been the right time. Or you might find your guy and it just, you need to, or your future guy's coming, man. So I think everybody, man, there's someone for everybody out here, man. I think maybe you just have to have your expectations not too high. So I don't know. Yes, you're right. Sex has no rules. I mean, at the end of the day, man, when it comes to sex, you're supposed to, man, be able to do everything, man. One thing I feel like, man, shit, like, if a guy hasn't done everything with his girl, I don't feel like that's your girl, man. I feel like there should be no path that you haven't done with your girl, man, that someone else has done. Now, eating the ass, man, if someone else eat the ass, man, I'm going to give him that, man. You know what I mean? I think I'm going to make up some other way, man. But I'm not going to do that. But at the end of the day, if you're with someone for so long, man, who knows what you're going to do, man, down the line. But me, personally, that's not where I'm at. I'm 50. I'll be dead by the time the right one comes along. You never know. Shit. The right one might come along and give you an extra 20. Might be the thing that changed your life, man. So don't always think that it's all over, man. You know, decent men don't lie. Don't like thumbs in it, but decent men. I agree. And I like to think I'm decent. So I don't like no thumb in my butt either. So I'm going to give you a thumbs up for that one. You know what I mean, Alicia? We don't need no thumbs up in the ass. But you know, shit, other niggas do that, man. You know what I mean? Finger popping ain't to me. I think it's a little fruity, man. But hey, man, again, man, I don't knock a person that goes full scale. If you go full scale, shit, nigga, with another guy, that's on you. That's what you do. You know what I mean? Just ain't what I'm going to do. You see what I'm saying? So, but I give the guy a thumbs up. Don't do that. That ain't cool. But yeah, man, so we're going to wrap this up, man. But I want you to just inbox me to some relationship questions, man. This is what we're going to be doing in the future, man. So we want, you know, you can drop it in the box so nobody knows, man. Drop some shit. And again, man, make sure you check me out on Wednesday, man. Me and Phoenix Fire, man. We're going to be doing some, you know, no chases, man. It's going to get more excited. We're going to be doing some crazy shit, reading some inserts from my book, man. So, you know, tune in, man. Make sure you come in 11 o'clock to 12 o'clock, man. We might do an extra hour. You know, no chases, man. Let's go, man. Make sure you support, man. You know, we always hold love, man. And again, man, inbox me some questions. And this is the final time, man, for the night, man. So thank you for tuning in again, man. Love y'all, man. Thank you. You should do a date show for us singles. I'm ready, man. You let me know, and I'm there. Tune in.